What is going on, everyone? My name is Triforce Addiction, and before we get into this topic, which is a pretty controversial one to begin with, I just want to let you guys know that I am very close to reaching 800 subscribers, and I need your guys' help to spread the word because I will be hosting a giveaway once I reach that amount. So the way the giveaway is going to work is that I'm going to start a live stream of basically pretty much any game, whatever game it is. And basically, it's just going to have like a giveaway title on that live stream, so you guys will know which one is the giveaway live stream. But anyways, the way it's going to work is that like about every 30 minutes, I will release a code for a Nintendo eShop. So basically, every code is going to have $20. So I'm going to be giving away maybe about 3 to 4 codes. It really depends on how much I really want. It's probably going to be 4. But anyways, yeah, that's how it's going to work. It's not really too complicated. Just every 30 minutes, I'll post a code in the comment section, and whoever redeems the code the fastest is pretty much the winner. So it's all fair game. So all you need to do is just to help me reach 800 subscribers. Just tell your friends, tell your family, whoever's interested in this channel, and just spread the word, man. Just spread it around Facebook, Twitter, or wherever you want. Amino, it doesn't really matter. But yeah, let's get this done as quick as possible, so you guys go get yourself some nice eShop codes. So the main topic I want to talk about today is basically how everyone is talking about this controversial move that Nintendo is making with the 3D All-Stars collection that will be released in about 10 days. So people are pretty upset about the fact that you could only get this game until March 2021. And yeah, apparently this is pissing off a lot of people. And of course, it is very understandable because, you know, not everyone can get this game day one, either if it's physical or digital. And of course, a lot of people or like kids want to save up their money to buy this game in the future, but they're pretty much on a time limit because, like I said, they only have until March of 2021 to actually get this game or else it's too late. So yeah, I do understand why people would be upset, but here's the thing. Like they said, it is a limited edition game. So I'm making this video pretty much to explain why this is justified. So for those of you guys who are subscribed to my channel, I don't know how old you guys are. You guys may be in your teen years or you guys are probably in your preteen, you know, you're like 10, 11 or 12. But I don't know if you guys were too young to remember, but 10 years ago when the 25th anniversary for the Mario Bros. Came out, there were a lot of limited edition items. For instance, we did have a limited edition DSi that was available at the time. This was right before the 3DS was announced. It was a pretty cool edition of a DSi. I never personally had one, but like seeing it, I understood why a lot of people wanted it. I'm sure some of you guys may have it somewhere. You know someone that actually has this limited edition DSi. But yeah, they came out with a lot of limited edition items. But the primary one that everyone wanted was the Mario 25th Anniversary All-Stars. So what this special bundle had was basically a 25th Anniversary Wii Remote. I think it was the color red. And also the game, of course, that has the Super Mario All-Stars SNES. So basically all the SNES versions of the Mario Bros, like, you know, Mario Bros 1, 2, the Lost Levels, and including Super Mario Bros 3. So of course, everyone wanted this special edition Mario bundle. And only a few that I know actually got this one. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get it. First, I was like, 12 or 13 years old. And honestly, I didn't have the money for that. And it was pretty expensive. So really, I pretty much missed out on the entire 25th anniversary collection. I didn't get anything that was related to the 25th anniversary of the Super Mario Brothers. So yeah, of course, I was let down. But at the same time, I kind of understood what was going on here. I understood why it was limited. Let's actually think about this, guys, real quick. You know, when it comes to an anniversary, if you're celebrating like a 50th anniversary of something, or let's say, for example, you're celebrating a wedding anniversary, right? You and your wife have been together for what? Like, let's say 10 years. And, you know, you want to do something special. And like, let's say you want to go to the Bahamas or whatever. It's like, you can only go that one time, you know, that one day or I guess that weekend. You can't really go like the next year and call it your 25th. Or your 10th anniversary, you know, it just seems weird. So if you get what I mean, like if it's like the 26th anniversary of Mario, why keep selling the 25th anniversary bundle? You know, it doesn't make sense. Limited edition items, specifically ones that are celebrating a certain year or a certain anniversary, should only be dedicated to that specific year. this is something that a lot of people need to understand about limited editions. It's only for a short time or a certain amount of time. And look, guys, like, even if I didn't have the money to buy this bundle or whatever, like, I still would understand, because when the 25th anniversary was around and, like, there was all these limited edition items and I didn't get a single one, I was okay with it. You know, like, if I didn't get it, like, that's too bad, but it's not the end of the world. But hey, guys, honestly, that's my opinion. If you don't like it, you don't have to. You know, everyone's entitled to their own opinion. But the main question that I have for this whole situation is that, like, why are they complaining about this now? It just seems really weird to me that, like, you know, we've had a ton of limited edition stuff come out for, like, either Mario, Zelda, or just any other game series out there. And people always have understood, like, why it's a limited edition. You know, it has to go away at some point. But, like, why, like, even back in the 25th anniversary, people understood that it was limited and it was going to go away soon. And people were okay with that. But, like, you know, when the 35th anniversary came out, it's like everyone's just, like, pissed that's going to be available for a limited time. It's like, dude, who cares? I mean, why do you care now? Let me give you an example. Like, for those of you guys who've been subscribed to my channel since pretty much the beginning, have you ever heard someone complain about the Battle for Bikini Bomb Rehydrated Fun Edition? Like, did anyone ever complain? It's like, oh, why does this have to be limited? Or why does this have to be so rare? No, because it's a limited edition collector's item. That's how it is. That's how it's always been. And, you know, I saw Review Tech USA and Spawnway's video talking about this whole situation. And, you know, they're calling it a very scumbag move. And I'm just like, wait, why is this a scumbag move? Why didn't you guys say anything back when the 25th anniversary was around, you know? Like, why is it a scumbag move now compared to before? I mean, it certainly wasn't a scumbag move 10 years ago. I mean, I don't know what changed your minds now, but yeah, I don't know. This whole thing is just confusing to me. Honestly, and no offense when I say this, like, the new wave of gamers have just gone completely, like, soft. I mean, if this was 10 years ago, and let's say 10 years ago would be the 35th anniversary or something, like, honestly, I don't think anyone would mind that it's limited. You know, it's like, people understood the definition of limited, but I guess now, like, people just, like, complain because they're not getting what they want. I mean, come on. Like, if I could take it like a man and not get the freaking 25th anniversary bundle, like, 10 years ago, like, I'm pretty sure you guys could live through this. Like, come on, guys. It's not the end of the world. So, yeah, this is just, like, my two cents on this whole situation. Like I said, it's my opinion. I'm entitled to it. If you guys don't like it, then, you know, I guess that's your problem or whatever. I mean, I don't really mind if someone disagrees with me. Let me know in the comments, actually, what you guys think about this whole situation. But anyways, my name is Triforce Addiction. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And remember to subscribe, because I will be hosting a giveaway once I reach 800 subscribers. Later, guys.